Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another status report highlight, this time for the 20th of November, 2018. And before we start off today, I'd just like to give some love to the Xbox player base. If you haven't heard, the Xbox beta version should be out on the 22nd of November. That's 2 days from the publishing of this video, so look out for that. And if you've been following my PC beta build videos, you'll see what there is kind of to expect. Base building, vehicles, and much more. Also, DayZ on Xbox is currently halfway through a 15% off sale. So if you felt like picking it up for the Xbox or you have a friend that's interested, now might be the best time to do so. And in today's video, we're going to see what the team has remaining to fix in the PC beta, as we are getting very close to that release of 1.0 in December. And lead producer Eugen is going to give us an update on the pressing issues from the last status report. We've made some progress on the pressing issues we listed the last time. Let's take a look. Hit registration. We have tackled and fixed a number of hit registration issues over the last couple of weeks. To be specific, I'm talking about the inventory manipulation of magazines through double click, which wasn't properly synchronized and caused ghost bullets. Another issue was with zeroing and reload initiated during scoping iron sights in a specific way. The most common issue was caused by problems in packet priority and networking. Overall, you shouldn't be seeing hit registration issues pop up too much anymore, and I highly recommend you to contact us through the feedback tracker if you experience weapons not dealing damage at all. While there are certainly some issues with damage itself left, it is tied to a balance pass and things will get ironed out. Changing keybinds. The next update should contain the keybinding UI, and while still work in progress, it should be a large improvement over what was possible before, and it will also finally be consistent with other UI elements in-game. FPS drops. With the investigation into FPS issues reported, we haven't gathered enough evidence yet. I would like to ask all of you experiencing a decrease over the last few patches to send us information about the server you play on, possible modification causing some drops, even economy changes causing more items to be placed on the map, their configuration and drivers to help us iron out exactly what happened and how. Internally, we haven't been able to reproduce it on any range of systems we have available, but we may be missing a crucial piece of information. Now let's move on to current issues. As I already mentioned, while fixing some things, we also managed to break them. Yep. Let's see what's broken. Server crashes. Vehicles issues. Broken play button. Persistence issues. Gun sounds missing. Sound stuck in a loop. Base building issues. Shotgun damage issues. Nighttime setup. Hit reaction and stun lock. And I know there's quite a lot of you out there that are not happy with the hit reaction / stun lock implementation currently. It can be quite frustrating, so that's good to hear that that is an issue at the moment. Can't wait for it to be fixed. And finally, VoIP issues. I will leave a link in the description below to the forum post where Eugen goes into more detail on the current issues, but for now, let's carry on. Next up, we're going to move to lead programmer Mirik, who starts by saying, "As we're all very busy with our tasks, I would just like to provide a quick bullet point overview of what we have done, what we are working on, and what we have planned for the upcoming weeks. As for the done section, car physics update. We had to rework the car physics controller as the suspension system was very unstable at low FPS, both server and client side. That'll explain a lot. Lowrider, anyone? Hit registration fixes. We've managed to fix one specific hit registration bug caused by packet ordering. Support for hearing sounds outside the network bubble. This can be configured in a server config. View distances are now also configurable via server config. Voiceover network fixes. We fixed specific issues with 5.1 and 7.1 headphones. Aligning characters on sloped ladders. Added script API for light sources. Our scripters and modders can now script the intensity, color, and size of light sources and dynamically change them. Support for additional character animations, e.g. sickness. Now let's look at in progress. Overall stability improvements, mostly crash fixes. Modding support, further script API extensions, file patching and security bug fixes. Further car physics tweaking. Input system, allowing the ability to assign keybinds. Fixes for applying damage texture to specific damage zones. And plans for the coming weeks? Continue with crash fixes, character physical controller fixes, and infected AI fixes. And now let's move on to lead animator Victor. We've been very focused on bug fixing and improvements to the existing animations and systems in these past 2 weeks. We have finished a pass on hundreds of in-game items, mostly updating their holding poses to make the animations look more natural, and also reduce various clipping issues. There are still some problematic items which will be up next, Other than that, we've also worked on bug fixes in the animation graph and animation polish for player character animations. One of the specific improvements is the addition of animations related to various sickness states. Player characters will be able to show signs of being sick by coughing or sneezing, and also show signs of being too warm or too cold. I just had an image of one survivor sneezing on a load of others and they all just kind of move away awkwardly. Oh god. Next up, let's move to sound designer Philip. We've been working on introducing additional variety to the sounds of player movement. That includes three different sounds for movement with a backpack, three new sets of sounds for various types of clothes, represented by the patrol jacket, raincoat, and quilted jacket, and noises for movement with the ghillie suit. By now, you have also probably discovered that the leaves are now rustling when players are moving through bushes and small trees. Finally, our infected received new voices, now totaling at 4 male and 2 female infected voice variations. Great work there, audio team. As I always say, audio is as important, if not more important, than visual sometimes. It brings the atmosphere and the immersion all together. Don't forget the official DayZ forums for those all-important feedback sessions. The next one coming up will be on gun mechanics, melee infected, and the damage system. I will leave links in the description to the status indicators in the HUD, character movement, gestures and actions, new actions and crafting and stamina. And that is pretty much it for the status report highlight for the 20th of November 2018. As always, don't forget to check out the community spotlight also put together by Beatty of your amazing community-created content. Links to that will be in the description also. And remember, this is a highlight. There is more information on the status report itself. Go check it out. I always recommend to read it in full yourselves. And finally, I just wanted to say a quick, huge thank you to the community. You guys watching the videos and jumping in our Discord, watching me on Twitch. It's really appreciated, guys. The channels and the Discord has exploded over the last few weeks. Beta has brought a lot of excitement as well as modding. Keep an eye on these channels and our Discord for all information regarding what we're doing next. And I'll see you peeps next time.